Hi, welcome to the Modern Renaissance Man Show. I'm Ben Copeland, Modern Renaissance Man, and Merry Christmas! You're watching the Christmas show for 2009, and who knows, maybe you're actually watching this in October of 2010 if we rerun it. But anyway, hope you're getting ready for some holidays, and we're close by on that with this show. Let me talk a little bit about political issues here real quick with you. Things like the health care. Speaking of Christmas and health care, they're having to change some children's songs. Did y'all know that? Associated with the new health care that part has passed, is the song that used to be All I Want for Christmas is My Two Front Teeth. And you know, it's All I Want for Christmas, My Two Front Teeth, My Two Front Teeth, My Two Front Teeth, All I Want for Christmas, Two Front Teeth, but I only get one because health care only buys that. Anyway. The House almost didn't pass the health care bill because the senior Democrats discovered that they wasn't going to pay for their prescriptions for Viagra, so they decided to go in and rewrite it. Rumor says, though, it still affected at least 20 pages if they didn't change it. And if you didn't get that joke, that's okay, too. Anyway, health care. I got on the internet and decided I wanted to see how many anagrams, if you know what an anagram is, how many anagrams I could find for Nancy Pelosi. And I plugged this in. I went through over 2,000 anagrams where you remake words out of those letters. And out of over 2,000 anagrams, I didn't find one that made enough sense to bring on this show. What does that tell me about Nancy Pelosi? Obviously, she doesn't make enough sense to be on the show either. Anyway, anagrams of Nancy Pelosi, you won't find anything that you can actually air. I saw a couple things, but they were degenerative and they can't be on tonight. If you'd like to know, send me some email, mrm@together.net. Maybe I'll share the Nancy Pelosi anagrams with you that you might like to hear about. Maybe not. I probably wouldn't want to send me email for that either. North Carolina. Do you know North Carolina has one of the few states that has sanctuary laws for illegal aliens? Sanctuary laws are laws that basically say police, when they stop somebody, they're not really supposed to ask them if they're a legal alien if they think they are an illegal alien. Did you know that? And that they're really supposed to avoid all the immigration topics. Now, tell me, now, with all the driving problems that we have with illegal immigrants around here, you think the police would be able to do that? North Carolina, which I always used to consider to be the most backwards of states, I think has progressed the wrong direction. No wonder we're getting such an influx of illegal aliens. Hey, you can come over here, and if anybody asks you one, you just deny it and drive on. Speaking about another interesting thing about illegal aliens, did you know that San Francisco now just passed a new law that says if you're caught driving without a license, period, they'll give you 20 minutes to call somebody up to come get your car so they don't impound the car. That's a pretty neat kind of feature. I guess next time if somebody breaks into a grocery store, they'll give you 20 minutes to take the stuff back in and let you go for that one, too. Well, that's San Francisco. It sounds like I'm getting on my soapbox. I believe I will. I wrote this out tonight. Sometimes I'm trying to avoid writing them, but this is basically a dialogue that I imagine happens sometimes between parents and their children concerning drugs and parents preaching about no drugs to their children. So it starts off like this. Drugs are bad for you. Alcohol is good for you, especially your heart. Drugs make you procrastinate. I like to have one or two drinks before cooking dinner. The kids don't mind. Drugs make you promiscuous. A glass or two of wine puts me in the mood. Drug leads to violence. I just avoid the mean drunks at parties and Chuck E. Cheese. Drug use leads to sexual diseases. At most bars, you can buy condoms now in the bathroom. Drugs lead to unwanted pregnancies. A glass of wine loosens me up for the night. Tobacco is a gateway to mind-altering drugs. I'll be glad when bars ban cigarettes. I can only stand to smoke for 3 or 4 drinks. Drug users do badly in school. I like to drink a couple beers while doing yard work. It's not dangerous. Tobacco is bad for your health. Hey, let's go after work and kill a few brain cells. Marijuana makes you forgetful. Hide the keys and don't tell them. They won't remember. Why would anyone intelligent take drugs? Let's load a cooler in the kids' wagon, and when we take them trick-or-treating, we can make them pull it for us. If only dopes do dope, then only alcoholics do alcohol. What do? And that's the way I feel. And with that, we're going to turn it over to the great music by the band Wavy Space. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas.
Excellent tune. I'm Ben Cope from Modern Renaissance Man. Merry Christmas, and you're joining us for hopefully another wonderful show tonight. If you're enjoying the Roman host cam, we're going to have some specials coming up here this year, and watch out for them. We have some musical specials with the band. We have a blurb middle show special, and we're going to have probably some mono specials and some spoke specials and whatever floats my boat special. And anyway, with that, what I'm going to go ahead and do is bring out a guest for this evening who's been with us quite a few times, Jennifer Sanders. You want to come on out?
Woo!
All right. Hey, hi. Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas to you.
I got a Christmas present there.
Yeah.
Anyway, we'll do it and do the host cam. It's actually been running.
The whole time?
Yeah, that's part of the time. Pictures are coming out these days. Yeah. We'll get James over there.
Yeah.
There he is. That's not really blood on his face, but it might be. But anyway. And, of course, the band. And hiding over in the corner is Kate S. Copeland, Roman host cam operator, and Barbara Coast host, and there's the band, They Hate Me. And Dan's back in the back somewhere. There they are waving. They're having Christmas cheer and partying and all of that. And we'll do some more of that on another show. Anyway, glad you could join us.
Thank you.
Your mama's Obama healthcare stuff. Something we hadn't done in a while that I want to do first. Library's great. Prices are great unless you're late. Charlotte Mecklenburg Public Library System, it is probably the best thing in this county. If you don't take advantage of it, you are on dope, or you should be. Anyway, with that said, I decided to go with military movies tonight, especially with our men and women over in the military tonight who are spending Christmas overseas, helping to protect our interest in peace and those of others who cannot protect themselves. Wonderful movie. Get it at the library. That's where I checked this one out. Steve McQueen, James Garner, Great Escape. And get a shot of that. Great movie. If you've never seen this movie, I don't care what age you are, Great Escape is a great movie.
It's so many people.
And have y'all seen the movie, Great Escape?
I have seen it.
It is a slick. Steve McQueen riding a motorcycle and James Garner in the plane.
There's just so many people in it.
Digging the tunnels.
Iconic.
Yeah, David McCallum.
That's a cool word. I like that. Iconic. I remember that. Iconic.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. That's our vocabulary lesson.
I didn't ask for the thing on the intro tonight. I forgot about that, of giving me the stump the host kind of guy.
Yeah,
I have to do that again.
I Fruit Loops, but she totally didn't respond.
Oh, okay. Well, that's probably because I'm sort of Fruit Loopy mode tonight. You know. Anyway, Great Escape. Go to the library. Prices are great unless you're late. I love the library.
Oh, they are good.
Anyway, we got a new mayor in Charlotte. First black mayor in 20 something whatever years.
Harvey Gantt was the last.
He was the last.
That's right.
And he got a African American Cultural Center named after him.
I know he did.
So I wonder what Fox would get.
Who knows? He really spent a lot of money.
I know nothing about it.
He spent a lot of money on this campaign, and he's been campaigning for a long time. I mean, he's been campaigning since he got on city council.
Well, I have to admit, and I'll admit this on TV, because I admitted that I voted for Obama, but I actually went the other direction this time. And it wasn't that I liked the other candidate. I just sort of felt like it's time to vote for the other side of the scales. And I was personally glad from a personal perspective that my person lost. Anyway, so we got Fox.
Yeah.
Hopefully he'll do well.
I think he will.
He's as pretty. Almost as Pat McCrory.
No one's as pretty as Pat.
Pat was pretty mayor. You know.
Yeah. He was a pretty guy.
He looked good. I wanted to see him in Raleigh just because he looked good.
He looked
pretty. Plus he'd represent Charlotte.
That's right.
So we have Fox. We'll see. That's what he does. And nothing else. It gives us more stuff to talk about on the show.
Maybe.
Yeah, hopefully it does. Hope something cool. Anyway. Do you know Pelosi turned sideways? Spell socialist.
I know.
Anyway.
She just had so. I was watching her the other day on Good Morning America.
Uh-huh.
And, you know, she can't. I guess Botox does it to you.
I don't know. She's had some facelift. She's about 2 inches taller.
You cannot have any facial expressions in your face.
Mm-hmm. I know. She's always plastic.
It's really sad because, you know, you really want to say, you know, if she had a genuine. Kind of look, you would never know it.
Because somebody just shocked, like off a roller coaster or something.
It's just frozen, you know, kind of thing.
Now she's talking about more taxes.
Well, of course. They have to.
She wants to do the value. I love
California
it.
California
has value-added tax. That's where they actually tax.
California has actually...
products through the different processes before they reach the end consumer.
They're doing that now.
They're wanting to do that. She's wanting to introduce that.
California has its own currency. They don't even have money now. They have a different currency. You know, people don't even understand. Mm-hmm. They're broke. I mean, it's just, you know, compounding on each other. People living in tent cities all outside of L.A.
That's because when they export people back to Mexico from California, they all turn around and say, I'll be back.
I'll be back. That's right. That's right.
Come on now. Schwarzenegger's the governor of it. Come on.
That bad.
That was the
imitation.
Good one.
I can't do I'll we'll be back with a we'll Hispanic accent. It doesn't work.
There is none.
It probably isn't.
It's true.
Anyway, ACLU, my favorite organization. Actually, they could be a great organization. ACLU could be a wonderful organization, but I think they just nitpick stuff that I just don't think's...
Well, they're busy trying to make sure everyone is accounted for and has their needs met.
Did you know they're suing the national park?
Oh, for the cross.
For the cross.
For the cross. Yeah,
so
I saw that.
They can't have a cross out there, you know.
Well, so. Yeah, in their mm-hmm. in their world, in their minds, still you couldn't.
So anything that's in a cross shape out there, wanting to destroy limbs and stuff
they
that's broken.
They would have to take
and
it down.
They want to take it down.
Anything even resembles
yep.
it. Yeah,
so
that's
no
right.
crosses, no, you know.
This
railroad
is
tracks
the one in
go
Colorado
across.
Or the one in...
This is the one I read about is Colorado.
Colorado, yeah. Yeah. Okay.
But I'd like to see them do a little bit more on victim rights. I don't hear anything. Maybe they do, but...
Nancy Grace does that.
Is
Nancy
she with ACLU?
The big eye. No.
Well, that's... Okay.
Nancy
I like
Grace
to hear the ACLU say, you know, it's time for people who are a victim of crime.
I think a lot of people are working more towards that now. I really do.
I'm not so sure.
I think they are. Think
we
they
have
are.
A we have a lot, particularly talking about the legal aid. That's all right. Just move furniture around. Just do whatever you want to do out there. You know, I mean, hey, you know, this is a live show. Anyway...
teaching me how
what
to sit.
What you want for Christmas?
I'm getting it. Disney World.
Oh, yeah, that's right.
Yeah, that's it. That's
we're probably, let's see, we're getting ready to leave.
Yeah, yeah.
We're leaving on the 23rd, the night of the 23rd. We're going to spend
8 o'clock, yeah.
The 24th through the 28th in Disney World with Tengazi and other people that are down there. So we're going to be Christmas mm-hmm. in Disney.
And, that's cool. Something we've always wanted to do.
Yeah. So Kay and I were talking about what we did because we're doing blurb shows and we'll air till next year. So, what's the first thing you want to do, Disney?
I want to do Expedition Everest.
Oh, you do? You like that one?
I do. I like that.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah. Yeah. And I don't know, just seeing the Wilderness Lodge. It's always great.
You know, they're going to have new tracks for Space Mountain.
Yeah. Well, I got sick, and I can't ride
you can't
the,
turn
left.
To the left. That
I can't
left,
do
that
the left,
left
track.
Hanging.
You can do the right
now watch
track.
The left side of Space Mountain. Go to the right.
I'm
talking about that inner thing.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know what it was.
Right
but
side.
But it made a big difference. Now, maybe it's also because we rode 15 times to the right before we went to the left, and the brain just couldn't handle it.
The left side of the left track shifted. Made me crazy, but the right side was cool. So, yeah.
Weird.
Well, that'd be a fun thing to do for Christmas. That's our Christmas present.
That's it. I do want a new tea towel. Pot and pan, you know, a skillet.
A skillet.
Yeah, it's making me crazy.
What kind of skillet?
No.
You want a cast iron?
I want a cast iron.
Cast iron skillets are pretty cool. Mm-hmm. Although people used to hit people with them.
Yeah. Well.
That's all right. Safety moment here.
I do want a cast iron.
Yeah, I like to have cast iron. Mm-hmm. I like to. And you can't mess them up, really. I mean, you know, you burn something in them. You just take some steel wool.
That's it.
Spread a little, you know, a little butter, a little grease on it, and there it's ready to go again.
That's it.
You know, versus where we're about scratching the Teflon stuff.
It peels
you
off.
Know,
now.
So, anyway, we're going to do some musical specials this year, band music that you don't get to see.
Well, you cut them off at the end.
Well, it's going to run out of time. But it's actually not the way to cut
that.
The show. Keeps them wanting for more.
I know, I
know it's coming. I'm waiting for the end.
I get involved
in
the
back.
And I'll say, this is one you're going to cut off, isn't it? And I go,
Let's get a shot of the band. The band's with us tonight. Maybe y'all want to do some opening music.
Yeah.
And they'll throw a camera over there. We got Ari, Janine, Shayna, and James in the back.
Keep him in the corner.
Yeah, everybody forgets the drummer. I mean, just look at Ringo Starr. He's not even knighted. I mean, he should have his knighthood just like the rest of the Beatles. Come on.
Yeah.
And all right, it should.
Camera one.
I mean,
Man, Ringo's the man, too.
And Ringo is.
He was in a movie that didn't have the other Beatles in.
Say that one, too.
Caveman.
He was in a movie that the other Beatles weren't in.
Caveman.
Huh? Oh, it was a great movie. Star.
He was the star.
He was the star.
He was the star.
His wife was in it, too.
Oh, and, that was a
Barbara
Bob.
I think he's still married to her.
No.
Yes.
So there you go. I mean, here's a guy who's been around since the 60s and went through all the drug culture stuff and the Hindu stuff and all of this and that. And, and basically is married to the same woman and for all this time. And
Barbara
and
Bob.
He's chic with his earring, is what he used to say. He's so cool. Richard Starkey. He should be knighted. Sir Richard.
Yeah, he's cool.
Come on, I'm the queen over in England.
He's a party animal, too.
He is. He's cool. I like him.
Yeah.
And you know, he's also, did you know he was on Thomas the Tank? You remember that TV show?
He played the little man.
He was one of the conductors.
The conductor.
Yeah, sure was. Ringo Starr was one of the conductors on Thomas the Tank. The other conductor that was real famous, and most people didn't realize, was George Carlin. So here you got the hippy-dippy weatherman. And one of the Beatles are on the conductors for a children's show.
Anybody ever tell you you look like George Carlin?
No, never, ever.
Never?
Never.
Aww. You're just not as funny.
Yeah. Not
all
one time.
He looks just like him. That's really
he
cool.
Does. Uh-huh. He does.
But I didn't do any of the stuff that he did.
Carlin,
yeah.
Not
yeah,
at all.
If he did, he probably would be on.
I was never on Ed Sheeran show.
That's right.
I love listening to his, he's got a book out. I've got the audio version of it. It's called When Will Jesus Bring the Pork Chops?
Did he read it?
He wrote
for
it.
The audio. No, he wrote it. But
yeah,
he
yeah, he actually reads. Yeah, he does it. Yeah.
It
would be. You couldn't have it without him doing it.
I know.
Yeah.
Okay.
That's great, actually.
That's good. That would be really sad.
No, it's very, very R-rated, particularly some chapters
George
of it.
Carlin.
Oh, I mean, like, it's R-rated for George. I mean, like, I'm sitting there like, whoa. I was almost embarrassed. I've been listening to George since I was, like 13. Actually, I vaguely remember on Ed Sullivan show. So if anybody remembers that, he's watching this.
When he had the tie, mm-hmm. In the old days when he used to dress real
smart. And that was his thing. Mm-hmm. He did the weatherman. That was the hippy-dippy weatherman was the first thing he did.
Right.
Let's flip over to something serious for a moment. Iraq and Afghan.
Right.
A stand.
Okay.
Should we be there?
Should we be there? You're asking me.
Sure.
Nothing
like a light topic here to go to.
5 minutes.
That's right. Go from George Carlin to... Iraq.
We have to be in Afghanistan now. Mm-hmm. That we have to be in. Just to make sure the country doesn't fold.
Mm-hmm.
Iraq, sure. Sure. Absolutely.
Why do you think so? For Iraq?
Well, I just believe that if we weren't there, again, the Taliban would be such a presence, a focus of that. So, yeah.
You know, one of the things I think about when I think about people who talk about we should never go to Iraq. Invaded that. Anyway, well, what if nobody ever went into Germany in World War II? I mean, we had a guy that got away with killing 10 million Jews and 20 million Russians before he was stopped. Saddam Hussein was a baby killer, and they had basically, he was gassing the Turks and all these people.
Well, unlike a lot of people in my age bracket, I'm really glad we got rid of the guy. Mm-hmm. I'm sorry.
I mentioned that, and somebody said, well, should we go after everybody? And I'm like, well...
Saddam Hussein.
If they're gassing babies,
Saddam Hussein was really.
But
evil.
Now here's the question: if it's yes that we should be there, what I want to know is, where is the free gas and the free opium? And
this is for real.
Coming into this country. Well, not necessarily.
That is
not
their, necessarily. That is their population.
But see, that is the problem. That's the problem is that the opium. Right. They need another industry. You can't just keep.
Shipping opium and
everybody be happy about that. They need to
I'm
make
interested
cars
to see what we're going to do with that.
That is their
industry.
They've got to create new
Period.
Industry because their cash product is opium and is dope, basically heroin and whatever else.
Poppy seeds.
Yeah, poppy seeds. Mm-hmm. And they got to create infrastructure.
Right.
But where is my free gas out of Iraq? I mean,
it's
over there.
Mm-hmm.
I think everybody ought to get 1,000 gallons right off the bat, for.
They went offline today just due to Ida coming in Louisiana. They took it off because they said now gas prices is going to be up next week.
We spent all their money over there helping them and getting the person out. Where's the freebie gas that we need to have?
Technically, it wouldn't be free if we spent all the money.
There we go.
Well, the freebie gas for me. Well, yeah, that's true. Where's the payback? The payback gas.
But it technically was your tax dollars in the first place.
That's true. So I've already paid for it.
Yeah.
So I should get my gas.
Yes.
That's right.
Yes.
Well, next time I go fill up at the store, I'm going to tell them, hey, I've already paid for this. send the bill to Obama. Anyway. We're slowly running out of time here. And few things I want to mention is that we do have a website, blog site. Blog is a weenie word for a geek word for a website or something like that, blog. www.mrmtv.org, or you can email me at mrm@together.net. Haven't received any good email or bad email in a while. Please send some. It's fun to read. Jump on the blog site. And on the blog site, we have shows. You have to watch them in any little size because that's the only way you can get them to fit onto the space limitations. But we have the band on there, and K.S. Copeland's on there, and we have some old shows from the beginning to shows current. So check out the website for that. Remember, merriment is a necessity. Alcohol is a drug. And we've got some nasty weather. Is what I wrote down here. We were having nasty weather. Speaking of nasty weather, thanks to the band and the crew and for coming out such an ugly night to help produce the show. Down with my director, Dean Smart, on audio. I was about to forget all them going on that door. See, that's why I looked down and saw that word nasty. I was just doing a nasty job. Anyway, Jennifer, thanks for being on. It's always wonderful to have you here.
Thank you.
You always have fun.
Yeah.
And I'm Ben Copeland, the modern Renaissance man. Merry, merry Christmas to you and yours. And well, some wonderful tunes. Man, wavy space.